I've got here a data center card that was never officially sold. These were only for Amazon Prime Video streaming. It's a Radeon Instinct Radeon Pro V540. On this end, which is actually the intake, I believe that's correct, you'll see a mini display port behind the shield here. And then on this end, you'll see an 8-pin EPS. On the back, you'll notice there are two interposer die complexes, two sets of VRM, and there's actually a chip in the middle that splits this. Makes running multiple of these cards in a rig very, very tough. However, makes it kind of interesting. In essence, what this is, as an oversimplification, is two Radeon BC160s, which in essence are two W5700 HBM cards stapled together. What I found while testing this card is it doesn't have enough power budget to really get insanely good efficiencies on both dies, but you could in theory run like Kawpow on one and ETC on the other and still stay within your power budget. So looking at the sheet here, I highlighted again in green what I thought was interesting, where this card really excelled. And since I did this on MMPoS, which is the OS that supports this, SRB 2.3.9, you guys know the saga. It's no longer supported by Dynex. They say it's fake hash rate. We'll see. I don't know. I plan on retesting a lot of cards when we get Wild Rig or BZ or the Deep Miner. So we'll see. But at the time, and we'll see if this holds up, this card was doing 71 hash per watt, which is really close to a Radeon 7. Very, very good. However, even if that's not the case, they still do 0.213 on Kawpow, which that's where you start running into the power management issue between the two cores. But in theory, you could run Kawpow on one of them at 0.213, and you could run ETC or ETHhash on the other at 0.59, which is nutty good. So ETHhash, ETC hash, these are really solid cards. Ergo, also pretty good, but I would say that they're better at ETH ETC than they are at Ergo. And the rest of it's pretty meh or pretty garbage. Like, I wouldn't consider those flux efficiencies good. Wouldn't even run Nexa, because the miner didn't know what the hell the card was. Core Algo's not doing it for me. So, really, it's a Kawpow, Dynex, ETH, Ergo card. But, again, you'd be hard-pressed to even find one of these right now. I found a reseller that had a bunch of these. Might have been a one and done, but certainly an interesting card to look at. And again, you need MMPoS just to mine with it in the first place. So if you're a Hive user, probably just avoid it. But hopefully you enjoyed looking at it. This super weird double 2048-bit HBM2 Samsung monster. And I just wonder how much Grand Tour went through this bad boy when it was in a server for Amazon. Anyway, thanks for watching. I will see you guys soon for another Oval Clocking video. Bye.